Hey guys, what's up? It's Charlie here, and today we're going to be looking at what happened to the first dog in space. We all know the astronauts who got all the credit for space exploration, but did you know that some of the first things in space were animals? On this channel, we've already looked at the first monkey in space. But now it's time for an even more sad story, the first dog in space. But before we blast off, why not subscribe and press the notification bell too? The dog at the center of this story is a female dog named Laika. Laika was born in 1954 on the 3rd of November in the Soviet Union. She was born in Moscow, USSR, which is now Moscow, Russia. Laika was actually what's known as a street dog. This is a dog which is kind of wild and out on the streets. So she had no home, but in 1955, she was taken by a Soviet space program engineer. She was taken by this man and selected to be on the Soviet spacecraft Sputnik 2. The mission of Sputnik 2 was to triumph their previous launch of Sputnik 1. They wanted to amaze the world with the power of the Soviet Union. Remember, at this time, the USSR and USA were at war. This was known as the Cold War, and during the Cold War was what was known as the Space Race. This was basically a race as to who could do space exploration better, the USA or the USSR. Well, for testing, Soviet officials decided to do something with Sputnik 2. They wanted to put a dog into the rocket to see how long dogs could survive in zero gravity. Sputnik 2 also had instruments for measuring solar interradiance and cosmic rays. It also had a life support machine with an oxygen generator. And inside was a fan which would activate whenever the cabin got over 15 degrees centigrade. This fan was added to make sure the dog would always be cool and would survive for a long time. Now, the mission was amazing as it was launching the first living thing into orbit. But the Soviets did not sugarcoat what was going to happen. They said Laika was not going to return alive. This caused outrage around the world that they would be sacrificing a dog. But despite the bad PR, the mission went ahead. As part of Laika's training, she did some suborbital flights. This is kind of like what astronauts do today before going out into space. It's done in a controlled, zero-gravity environment. And really, it's done in a zero-gravity room. It's not done in a spaceship. Also, to help Laika adapt to Sputnik 2, she was kept in a smaller cage for 20 days before the mission. This caused Laika's blood pressure to double, and she also began to get quite ill and restless. Laika was also trained to eat a high nutrition gel that would be in her space food. One day before the launch, one of the engineers for the Soviet space program took Laika home to play with his kids. The man was named Dr. Vladimir Yadovsky. He later wrote in his novel that Laika was very quiet and charming. He said he took her home to play with his kids to do something nice for Laika. He knew she had little time left to live and wanted her to have a nice final day on Earth. But he kind of felt too bad for Laika as she was still put into the rocket by him. Then on the 3rd of November 1957, Sputnik 2 launched. Liftoff occurred at 5:30 a.m. Moscow time. At first it was normal and Laika got into outer space. The rocket was supposed to split into two, but there was an error and part of it did not separate. This caused their thermal control system to malfunction. Remember how I told you about the fan and the cooling system they put in before? Yeah, that stopped working and Laika began to overheat. The cabin was not supposed to get above 15 degrees centigrade, but instead it got up to 40 degrees centigrade. Sadly, Laika had nowhere to go and could do nothing but wait until she passed away. Within a few minutes, Laika did overheat and passed away. This is a very sad way to go. She was actually supposed to be poisoned by a poisoned food package the scientists had put in the rocket. But instead, sadly from this malfunction, Laika passed away from overheating. For about 5 months, Sputnik 2 and Laika's body revolved around Earth. It floated in space and orbited the Earth 2,570 times. Then, 162 days after the launch, Sputnik 2 re-entered the Earth's atmosphere. However, in re-entry to the Earth's atmosphere, Sputnik 2 burnt up. And of course, so did Laika's remains. At first, the Soviet Union said that Laika had passed away painlessly in orbit. And they said it happened about a week after blastoff. But that was actually not the case. Obviously, after the blastoff, it took Laika just a few hours to pass away. And sadly, it likely was not painless at all. The USSR said this so they wouldn't get bad publicity, and also so that they looked better in the space race. But many years later in 2002, the real truth about what happened was revealed. Laika now has a big legacy in Russia and around the world. In Moscow, there's a statue devoted to Laika. And it also brought up many ethical questions about the USA and USSR using animals for the space race. And after Laika, all future space missions carrying dogs were designed to be recovered. So that was the sad story of Laika in space. But now it's time to make your opinion heard. Who do you think won the space race, the USSR or the USA? The USSR got the first man and animal into space. However, the USA had the first man to land on the moon. If you guys want some more amazing videos, then check out my second channel. There'll be a link to that on screen in a moment. But as always, thanks for watching. Check out some more videos on screen right now. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.